This is a video showing how to independently set the sampling rates for measurements within a multi-measure sensor. In this case, I've connected a smart cart to my PASCO Capstone software. You can see there's a large variety of different measurements that we can collect using the smart cart. What we're going to do is we're going to reduce the sampling rate for the measurements that we're not going to use to enable a larger bandwidth for the measurements that we do want to take a look at. So to close this drawer down, I'll click on the Hardware Setup button again. To adjust the sampling rates, I'll go to the bottom of my screen. By default, it's going to have the sampling rates for the Smart Cart 4 sensor. I'll click on this, and then I'm going to select Common Rate. I'm going to want to reduce this common rate to the lowest value possible, so that we'll free up bandwidth for the sensors that we, or measurements rather, that we want to use. So I can go ahead and reduce it all the way down to 12 hours. Anything more than the length of the run will mean that you'll only record one measurement for the entire run. Next, I'm going to click on the common rate again, and I'm going to select the sensor that I wish to increase the sampling rate on. In this case, I'll take a look at the Smart Cart 4 sensor. This has taken on the value of the common sampling rate, but I can change that independently. Now I'm going to use the up arrow and increase the sampling rate up to the value that will be helpful for my measurements. Usually for collisions, we can go up to 250 Hz if needed, or higher if it's going to be an impact with a much stiffer spring. Once I've adjusted this value, I'm now ready to click on record and perform my experiment.